Just do whatever you're gonna do. Okay. You search the map for places the signal bounced through. I'll lock them in, and once we've found enough of them, we should have the route Blood Alpha Dooley took. Oh boy, a little minigame here. Search the map for places the signal bounced through. Cool song. How do I do this? So just like exploring, is that what we're doing? Cool song. Not sure I understand what I'm supposed to be doing here. Oh wait. What do I do now? So I'm supposed to know where I'm supposed to figure out where it went next. These land masses? You've got two songs going on at once, though. Now, the click knees doesn't do anything, right? Wait. Okay, can be in the middle of the water. So there's really not much to this, it's just looking for the next signal bounce or something. I don't know why they're playing both songs at once. Somehow I don't think that was supposed to happen. So where'd it go next? Did it bounce back over here somewhere? This isn't the best. It's a little boring. So where do you think it would go next? Back out into the... Back out this way? Did I just see another one? Oh, over here. I like blinked at that moment. Feel like we're on a roll now. Huh, looks like a map of the lake. Emily says, to what? Devin says, to where? Or Amelia says, to Dooley? Not sure, let's print it out and see where it leads us. Received a map. A printout of the lake with the route Dooley took. Anything else new to say? I'm not talking to you anymore, Detective. Well, how about that? It's ringing again. Them again? Hello? Hello, me again. Just wanted to make sure you were aware that Devin is allergic to technology. Bitten by a toaster once. He has left his EMP device at home. I wouldn't sleep a wink thinking of him out there in a tech-filled wilderness without knowing that your EMP is up and running. In fact, maybe you'd send me the make and model num- Hello? Hello, Barbara? I think the line has gone dead. How would we hear the- Let's see if I can ask her anything else. I don't know. No. Back to the lake. To the boat. I guess now that it's working, I best head out and check the lake. Devin says, we best head out, mister. Too dangerous, kids. Tell you what, you keep an eye out here in case Dooley comes back and I miss him. Emily says, but danger is my middle name. Amelia says, no, it's not. They just write danger in all your paperwork. Oh. Devin says, we have to go, mister. We have to. It's against my better judgment, but then most things I do are. In you get. Okay. There's a reporter. Got a camera. Dick Brickman. Oh, we've heard about you. Hands off the camera. We're rolling. It's a Polaroid camera. An unmanned Polaroid camera. Doesn't matter. Dick Brickman will get his man, or monster, on tape. And you can rest assured that I'm not going anywhere until I do. Unless I had reason to believe the monster is hiding somewhere else. Oh, we're gonna need to move him or something? Let's talk to Devin. If I had a camera, I'd take pictures of bugs and fish and rocks and another fish because there's more than one type of fish. Amelia? I wonder if this guy has his Ask the Real Questions badge. I'm gonna regret this, but what are the real questions? Which computer has Elvis been uploaded to? Who funded Columbus's fake discovery of America? Where... Sorry, the faked discovery of America? Yeah. Dooley says this is no actual proof America exists. That right now we're actually in a secret country in the middle of the Alps. That's impressive, even for Dooley. Emily? When do we get to police brutality of the press? That's not a thing we're going to do. How do you get any joy from this job? Alright, so... Look at the moon again. Oh, it's the same thing. Same dialogue. Joking with the moon, yes. Okay. Hey, I recognize you. Dick Brickman here, reporting from here, the place I am, to you, wherever you are, for the Twin Lake News with me, Dick Brickman. What are you doing here? I, Dick Brickman, am here to report the news, and the news of the day is that there is a monster living in this lake. That's not really breaking news, is it? People have been talking about the supposed monster for an age. Breaking news? Police admit to knowing about the monster for, and I quote, an age. How did you get here? I don't see a boat. You can't keep the press out, and I, Dick Brickman, am the press. So what's the scoop on the monster? We're here, live, at the scene where the investigation has taken us thus far. What will we see? Is this where the monster lives? Will we finally get a signed photo of the creature? Tune in as soon as I, Dick Brickman of the Twin Lakes News, have absolutely anything to share. You know there's no audience here, right? No need to talk like you're mid-broadcast. Breaking news, Detective. You're here. An audience of four. An audience of 4 or 4 million, the news has to be heard. Don't forget to tune into the Twin Lake News with me, Dick Brickman, for the thrilling conclusion of this week's Dick Brickman Investigates, featuring me, Dick Brickman. Where I, Dick Brickman, will follow any lead on the creature, any lead at all. Okay, I'm kind of tired of saying his name. Alright, let's go to the forest. I think we're lost. Armelia says, pretty creepy place. I bet there are monsters in that forest. Let's hope not. There's fireflies. Fireflies! Flies on fire! Dark forest. I wonder what secrets this forest hides. Not that I have any real urge to find out. Let's talk to Devin. I don't like dark things, like the night and dark... Like the dark and night, Tim? Do you mean nighttime? I don't like nighttime, but that's only because when Night Tim comes to whisper in my ear about the crushing realities of adulthood. Okay, Emily. I've buried many unwanted gifts in these woods. And Amelia. Can't you orienteer us through these woods? That's a scout thing. Instead, we'd learn how to block ourselves from the all-seeing eye of GPS satellites. Cave mouth. Okay. The jetty is this. Okay. Anything else to look at? Dark forest. Fireflies. Cave mouth. Badly hidden cave entrance. Sign. Nothing in here, no siree. Devin says, I guess we should keep looking then. You really are a Dooley student. Okay, Devin? Do cave mouths have cave teeth and cave tongues too? Emily? I bet that cave has spiders in it. And bats. And bat spiders. I want a pet bat spider. Interesting. I kind of want one too. Armelia. I may need you to keep the other two occupied while I investigate that cave. Perfect. That should give me all the time I need. Time? What for? I've nearly spent enough time waiting beside cave mouths to get my waiting around by a cave mouth badge. Why is that a thing? When will that come in useful? Well, we're waiting beside a cave mouth right now, aren't we? See how good I am at it? That's because I've been working on getting the badge. Okay, whatever. Let's go into the badly hidden cave entrance. There seems to be a cave behind that obviously fake cover. Emily says, let's go. You guys should guard out here. Emily says, okay, I'm gonna mess up anyone who comes near. Oh. Nigel, who is a monster. Is the narc still out there? He's getting so close. Dooley says, I have a look. Oh, hey, detective. Dooley. What's going on here? Dooley says, huh? Oh, this is Nigel. Hi. He's a fellow truthy. Invited me here to help with a problem. Right. Are you done? Can we go? Nigel says, no and, no. I need Dooley's help. Dooluminati.com and he are famous in truthy circles, you know. What's the problem? The government wants me because I'm a monster. A talking monster. Frankly, I'm surprised you haven't noticed. Anyway, I need protection. Like a gun? Dooley says, look at this guy. Let's solve everything by shooting it. I don't even own a gun. Stop talking about guns. I'm sensitive about my lack of fingers. Dooley says, we need to chase off that narc outside. They're closing in on Nigel and fast. Narc? You mean the reporter? Nigel says, clearly a government spy. No, we get rid of him. Dooley says, and once he's gone, what you need, Nigel, is a mind hat. That'll keep him off your trail. A mind hat? Is it a thing of aluminum, like dunce cap? A protective layer of some kind of metal. Maybe aluminum. Do you mean a tinfoil hat? Dooley says, that sounds perfect. That'll stop them from using your mind waves to locate you. Genius. I knew you'd be able to help. Okay. Alright, let's look at the everything else first. The toupee. Do you like that? It's my human disguise. That's how I got into camp and convinced Dooley into coming with me. Dooley says, I was certain he was another Blood Alpha. Very believable. Someday I hope to work in a film makeup department. I think I have a knack for it. Arts and crafts table? It's full of fake jamboree flyers in various stages of readiness. His lack of hands explains the childlike nature of the posters. But nothing explains how we got a crafts table and computer in here. I got ink. This must be the ink he used to write his flyers and signs. There's still some left. A few well-placed swirls and... I got a faked sighting. The smudges look vaguely sea monster-ish. Should convince people he is elsewhere. Tape? Sticky tape. A staple in every adventurer's toolkit. Used for sticking things together, usually my fingers to each other. So it's a staple, but we haven't had it until now. What's in the bin? It's full of seafood takeaway wrappers. Nigel says, don't judge me! Computer... Alright, let's talk to Nigel. Hi? So, a monster. A talking monster, but I don't like to talk about it. We're all God's creatures, I guess. Is that right? We don't have much religious stuff under the sea. I just read the books I stole, borrowed from the campsite. I'm not sure. What are you doing in Twin Lakes? It has good dental plans. But you don't have teeth. But if I did, this would be the place to be. Kidnapping, eh? I think that's an unfair way to describe luring somebody to a place under false pretense. Trapping them in a cavernous lair and refusing to let them leave. What do you think the government are... Why do you think the government are after you? Hollywood. I'd be cheaper than CGI and monster movies are all the rage these days. But I'm not interested in a life of fame. I'd prefer to work in makeup and help the real stars shine. Chat later. Alright. What's up, Dooley? Are you okay, Dooley? Yep, it's quite nice here. But since I can't leave, maybe you could help protect Nigel from the Narc? Just get rid of that guy outside and then get the mine hat to keep them from finding him again. Dooley, the guy outside is a journalist. From TV. Perfect cover. Oh boy, those government types are crafty. Best convince them that Nigel is hiding out somewhere else. Get them off his tail. Alright, let's look at the computer. It's open on the same forum page as Dooley's machine was, and the keys are damp. Very damp. I don't know. I'm not sure how we're supposed to take that. Okay, gang, the good news is that Dooley is inside and is safe. The bad news is that he can't come out yet. Why not? Armelia says. It's a Blood Alpha test. It's for your Don't Ask Questions badge. Yes. I've been waiting for that one for ages. Let's do this. Well, did you get to wait for long enough? Can you really wait outside a cave for long enough? The answer to that is no, but to your question, yes. That badge is going to be mine. As soon as we get Dooley back. Alright, let's go... this guy the fake sighting. Let's see. Yeah. Goodness me! Oh my! Breaking news, the monster has been sighted elsewhere. This is me, Dick Brickman, signing off so I can sign back on another day from another bay. Okay, he's gone. He left his camera. Well, I said that myself and then it printed it on the screen. I guess I should bring it back to Lost and Found. Got a camera. Dick Brickman's Polaroid camera. Alright, so do we report back? What is this thing here? Is this anything? No. Didn't say anything different. The reporter is gone. Do you have the hat? The tinfoil hat? Not yet. Please hurry. I know they're trying to lick my brain. I can feel it. Trying to lick your brain? Is the narc gone? He's gone. Is the hat ready? Not yet. There's no time to waste, detective. You need to make that protection device. So where are we gonna get tinfoil from? The kitchen? I need tinfoil. Think you guys can help me out? Sure. Oh, great. No way, Barry. Aunt Tracy made this for us and they'll get soggy if we give away our tinfoil. You're right, you're right. We might be waiting for a long time for that monster to show up. And until we see some proof there's a monster here, we're staying, which means the foil stays here too. Sorry, detective. Oh, damn. Back to my original plan. Oh god, I was ringing again. What do you have to say this time? Hello? Me again. It just popped into my mind that I don't know the mix of fibers in Devin's uniform, and he may be near, though not too near, I hope, fire while at camp. Could you tell me the composition? And while you're at it, could you run me through your fire plan? Just the basics will do. Staff training, frequency of extinguisher tests, your list of emergency helicopter pilot number... Jack, who are you on the phone to? Nobody, darling. Oh, brother. Got any tinfoil? This is a canteen. Of course we got the tinfoil. Can I have some? Nope. This is for kitchen use only. Oh, damn. But I want it. Where the hell else are we supposed to get tinfoil? We've already found Dooley. Like moths to a flame. They're not moths, they're flies. Yes, but they're like moths to... They're flies. Flies. Taper up. Traitor. Oh, sorry, because I wouldn't give her the gas. waiting for the phone to ring again. Take your picture? Tape her up and then take the tinfoil. I like the sounds the doors make. I don't know. Tinfoil. Flies. I don't know. Take a picture of the monster? I don't know. We're gonna find this. I'm getting stuck on this stuff here. Back and forth across the lake. Let's talk to this girl again. This lady, sorry. No. I could get these guys to dress up as a monster, but I need to find somewhere nobody will see. Otherwise, the disguise will be spoiled. Alright, that's what we're gonna do. So why will people see there? So where is a place that no one will see? I guess in the woods? Who's gonna see over here? Let's see what kind of outfit we can make out of all this. Ha ha ha. Wow. Bigfoot. Utterly convincing. Utterly unconvincing. We can't walk in this. Can we take it off? I guess. Wait. Alright. We gotta take a picture of it. This is the only place we can take it. Okay, game, back into the Bigfoot outfit. Say, whatever Bigfoots say when they're having their picture taken. Wait, should that be Big Feet? Big Feets? Photographic evidence. Sure. As authentic as a photo of Bigfoot as I suspect exists anywhere. Is it odd that despite my line of work and experiences thus far, I find Bigfoot hard to believe in? Okay, now we gotta show it to these guys and get their tinfoil. Look what I found. I found a photo you two may be interested in. Some proof! Finally! We knew he was real. Wait until we show the gang. Okay, now we can get into their goodies. They seem to have left their cooler. Food and tinfoil. I love some of that. Tinfoil. There's nothing left. You said food, and I didn't take that. Some tinfoil. If I can stick it together, I can make a tinfoil hat. If only my parents could see me now. Okay, let's do this. Oh, brother. Well, this isn't actually that bad. Where's the other park? Are they here? No. These can't be, like, switched around, can they? No. Here. This goes there. Not so bad so far. Ta-da! That should do it! Now I just need to tape this here, fold that there, and voila, a tinfoil hat. I better take this back to the cave and give it to Nigel. You can see the tinfoil hat, yes. You'd think having made a tinfoil hat for a talking monster would seem strange to me. This job is making me jaded. I should probably stay and give Nigel his stupid hat. Is the narc gone? He's gone. Is the hat ready? It is. Then give it to Nigel, there's no time to waste. The reporter is gone. Do you have the hat? I do. Please give it to me. I can feel them rubbing their oily hands on my brain. Oh, same thing. Give them the hat. Here you go. It's a thing of beauty. Now what? With the narc distracted and Nigel untraceable, it's time for him to find a new life, free from the watchful eye of the man. Can we stay in touch? Nigel says. Of course. Just email me from hard-to-trace locations like phone books, coffee shops, and the Mariana Trench. Okay, then. Thanks again, Dooley. I'm speechless. Poor guy. I hope he shakes off those government narcs. Dooley, where government narcs? Speak for yourself. I don't tell the man nothing. It's good to have you back, Dooley. Rev Splutter. The petrol. Looks like you're staying here with us. S'mores all around. Who are the bloodiest wolves around? Who keep the sniffers to the ground? We do! We do! Case closed. Okay, that one was... different. Are we... Did we get louder again? No. It just seems loud. Hmm. Well, stay tuned for the next episode for Dawn of the Dead. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.